What's up, everybody? I just wanted to do a quick video. I always keep on saying it's a quick video and it never ends up being a quick video. But I just wanted to thank everybody for actually watching the tour that I did of my cargo trailer camper conversion. If you haven't seen it yet, look in my videos in my playlist and you'll see I did a kind of a lengthy tour of my 6x12 cargo camper conversion. And I am dumbfounded. Less than 2 weeks, it's got 20,000 views. I never would expect that, but I want to thank everybody for viewing it and liking it and subscribing as well. But with that being said, one of the main questions that I had on that video was the air conditioning unit. Now, I know there's many different ways to go about doing an air conditioning unit, and you're going to have the diehard guys that say nothing but a mini split, and you got some people that are just dead set on using those portable units. Personally, the portable units here in Florida, it's not going to work. They're not very, very, they're not very efficient, if you will. And then also, you got the portable or the window units as well. And, some people are just against the window units as well, but I'm here to tell you. So if you're going to do a window unit, I think that's the best way to go for doing a budget build. So this unit is like less than $200, maybe $229 on the high end right now. So yes, I mean, you got some people that are diehard mini split people. You also got to understand there's people out there that just want an affordable way to use an air conditioning. Also, you might not be in Florida. You might be in the Midwest and you only need it very minimal times during the summer months while you're up there. So this is a kind of a video for that. So what I did was, during the build, I did some videos of me installing this unit and the way I went about it. So I did get a lot of questions on how I did that. So here we go. First off, I just wanted to show you, this is obviously the finished camper. Everything in here is done. Everything is accessible in this unit. I have a couple of screws that come out right here. This surround behind this comes out. And then when you open these up, I have panels on each side that I can pull out, and I just pull this thing out, and if it ever takes a crap, again, for $175, $200, I'm putting a new one in, and it's good to go. All right. So, and then also, everything in this unit is sectioned off correctly and behind the unit. You're gonna see I used foil board and insulation, and I made like a styrofoam box for that sections off the exhaust itself, and then there's enough room to go around it for air intake as well. And then as far as drainage goes, you'll see that as well. I came up with a really neat plan for the drainage as well. Again, we'll get into some details in the videos and stuff like that. These units, at least this one does, it has a little rubber grommet in the bottom of the unit that you can let take out to let the condensation out. There's things on Amazon, like a little petcock that'll go in that hole, and then you just run the tube out. But in my experience, I found that these things condensate more than just where that little hole is. I mean, it sweats all up and down on the bottom side of this unit, as well as the back. You'll see the coils in the back a lot of the times. Like if you were to go outside right now, if you had a window unit, you're going to see in the back of that unit, there's water tucked down in there as well. And basically what I did was I made a pan that fits this perfectly, that goes up above these them coils just ever so slightly. And you'll see that in the video. So I just wanted to give you a rundown on that. And then next, you'll see on the outside, I used 6-inch marine hatches initially for the air intake and the exhaust. And I mean, they're good on sunny days and dry days, but they're not so good on heavy duty rain days. And you'll see that I actually, I had problems with this originally. There is a couple of times it rained out pretty hard, and those exhaust fans and intake fans will actually suck that water right in. And I had it all within the bottom of this camper at one time. Luckily enough, it was in the infancy of the build and stuff like that. It was, none of this stuff was in here and stuff, but right now it's completely bone dry. I came up with a concept that works really, really well. So again, 6-inch marine hatches on the outside, but I'll show you here within the video how I actually made them a little bit more watertight.
All right, good morning. Quick little video on the cargo camper air conditioners that I'm putting in. So we got two marine hatches up front. This one is for exhaust. This one is for intake. If you take a close look, there's mesh in each one of them. And then there's also an exhaust fan. I use 4-inch Dayton fans in there. All right, so sorry for the mess in here. You know, guys know how it is when you build a camper. You got crap everywhere. All right, so here's the unit I'm putting in. It's a GE unit. It's a smaller, that's a 6,000 BTU. First off, let me say I live in Florida and this is my second build. The first one turned out phenomenal and I loved it. But I put the first unit in the V-nose on the ground, and I see so many people putting them on the ground. I'm gonna tell you right now, in Florida, that is so inefficient. I had to run an external fan near the bed, and it just didn't work well. I understand it's very easy to drain and stuff out the back end, and then also the exhaust and stuff, but I'm telling you, mine never kept up in this Florida heat. So what I have here now is, I'm doing an overhead unit all the way to the roof. I don't know if you can really tell, but everything is sectioned off. So it's kind of shaped at an angle on each side. So it's kind of like a trapezoid on each side, but everything is accessible. So I got it all foiled out pretty much all the way. If you take a look, there's the exhaust. The exhaust is all sectioned out. It has the exhaust fan back there, you can see spinning a little bit, intake fan right there, and then these side panels, each side panel comes off, so if I ever have to get back there to do whatever once the unit's in there, I can. It also has these little pieces right here, so the bottom obviously goes to the bottom, and these fit inside the unit perfectly. Here's the right leg, which I'm trying to do this one-handed like everybody says on YouTube. I'm trying to do this right-handed and make a video. So that goes in there, and then obviously the top will go up here in the top, and then once the unit's in there, it's all encapsulated. And it's perfect. So basically what I did is I just took two pieces of 1-inch, that isofoam, that poly board with the aluminum foil on it, and just taped it up with metal tape. And as long as I keep on buying the same unit, the same size unit, these will last forever. Okay, so we'll take that out real quick. Now, the reason I'm really doing this video, because there's quite a few videos on how to put a unit, air conditioner unit, and make it stealth in your YouTube or in your cargo trailer conversion, is everybody always asks, how is it holding up? What about the drainage? And so that's a big concern on here. So basically, as you can see, I ran this thing for about an hour, and right there, this is a wet spot. It worked phenomenal, but it's already bubbled up. So what I'm doing is what everybody else says to do, put in a pan. So what I did was I bought this very expensive piece of 24 by 24 inch aluminum. I think it was like $36 for this piece of aluminum. And I am going to build a pan. Now, my thoughts were, basically where this line is, I was planning on cutting this line all the way back to this back area and cutting it out, and then making the pan slant down at an angle and then have a catch on it. Now, I know a lot of people will just put a drainage line from the AC unit itself. The ones that I've seen for my unit right here are basically something you can get off of Amazon, and it's just basically a tube and this little bung type thing that you gotta kind of drill out and then pop it in, and everybody's saying that they break real easy. In my eyes, that's not the only place that these things are leaking out of as well. So when you have these units, you have water that catches right in here as well, that's back by the exhaust. So my plan is to make a pan that kind of comes up just a little bit higher on here, and then on the sides as well. And again, make it kind of slant out at an angle. So, like I was saying, this is the back side. That pan will be a little bit higher right here, so it catches any water that goes down. I might angle that back edge down a little bit. Might have to take a little bit of this off and reconfigure it, but it'll catch all that water. And then I'm gonna have a drainage in the pan itself. So I'll take out the rubber grommet, which I've already done. This little red rubber grommet right here is at the bottom of the units of my air conditioning unit. And just have it subtly go down into the pan. The pan will catch everything. And then I will run a hole and then route it down, out, down the bottom. So wish me luck. All right, so here's the start of the pan. It fits in between those. Basically just bent these up real quick. Now I'm gonna bend up the back, and then I'm gonna try and bend up the front just slightly. I only need a very, very small lip. So we'll give it a whirl. All right, so here's what I come up with. It's not pretty, but it'll work. So a little bit of an edge right here, a little bit of a taller edge in the back. Like I said, that will catch the water that kind of comes over from the exhaust. On the sides, these are just high enough to just not hit the cold air vents or cold air intake vents. And yeah, so basically, it'll just fit in there. I've already marked out where the exact hole is from the air conditioning unit. When I take out that rubber grommet, it'll drip straight down into that. And I still don't know what I'm gonna do yet. I'm gonna drill a hole probably in this wood, maybe large enough. And what I thought about doing was kind of taking a hammer maybe or something and pounding it down a little bit more to kind of give an angle, but I haven't decided yet. All right, so we're gonna build the drain. So what I found was this from Lowe's, some clamps to put the bilge pump, or the bilge hose, I'm sorry. I'm gonna use this bilge hose. It's super big, so that'll work out great. And then some Flexol. And I'll show you how I'm gonna go about putting this into that drain pan right there. So what I got here is this little sink, cheap sink plug. I think it was like $10. I don't know what it is, like a little cheap sink thing. Drain. Drilled a hole through that. Drilled a hole right there. Once we get that in, I'm gonna use like spray adhesive to keep this down. This will also keep it in place right here. So that fits in there perfectly. But if you look, there's a little bit of a gap on there. So what I'm going to do, I am going to, let me put this down. I'm going to router out just a little bit around this edge. So it's gonna be a recess. So when I use that nut on the back side here, it's gonna suck it in. All right, so here's the concept. It's not a pretty route, but so when we put this in, see how it goes down? So when I put the metal pan in here and suck this down with this nut down on this side right here, it'll suck it down and pull that tight, and then it'll give it a natural gradation to come down to that hole, and that should work. Alright, so the nut is in, and that sucked in pretty nice. So what I'll do is I'll end up silicone all the corners in here, all four corners, and then just to be on the safe side, I got some Flex Seal. I'm going to try and go over the top of it as well. And then I'm just going to run this tube right here. This tube fits in here pretty good. What I'll do is I'll end up cutting this a little bit and seeing if I can't manipulate this, because that's obviously hanging a little bit lower than I'd like. I think if we cut a little bit of this, grind some of this off, slide it up, use a clamp, I think we'll be fine. All right, so there it is. Drip pan down to the drain. Goes right out the nose. I didn't see how long I left it. Oh yeah, quite long under there. Definitely need to cut some of that off. All right, so here's the pan installed. It's got a little bit of a drip edge right here that just fits under that. And then what I did was, you can see right here, I kind of made it go over the air intakes just a little bit. And yeah, I think it's gonna work well. So we got it all back together. I just wanted to guys kind of show you. It's got the top pieces, the leg pieces that all fit in there. Everything fits in there very snug. So it ain't going anywhere. And then this is gonna be the intake side. So you can see there's more than enough room to get all this air to get over these coils, or I mean into this fan, all the way on that side. And then if you go over here, right here as well, more than enough room to get in there. And then I got panels that go in here, these two panels right here that close that all up. All right, and lastly, so here are my vents. As you can see, I got a couple of squared off vents. What those are just $17 dryer vents that you can get from Lowe's or Home Depot. Now they do come in white, so I had to paint them black. But if you can take a look up in there, hopefully it's, let's go look at this one once. So, like I said in the beginning of the video, I do have 6-inch marine hatches in there. And actually, as you can see, here's the cover to one of them. I had another question in the comments of my last video is, how do you keep it watertight when you're driving down the road? Well, this seal just goes right up in there. I'm not gonna tighten it down super hard, but you get the concept. So basically, I'm covering up those exhaust fans, and I don't have to worry about any water splash coming from the vehicle or anything like that if it's raining and in transit. So basically, these units right here, $17. All I did was run the 4 screws in the corners like they give you, and then I just run butyl tape around the sides of it. And I have had no water leakage whatsoever in this unit. And it's been about, I think I'm going on 3 or 4 months that I've had this build completed, and no problems with the air conditioning at all. So with that being said, I hope you guys got something out of this video. If you could, comment, like, subscribe, and till next time, thanks a lot.